So you have created some concept art for a mouse design, or maybe you have some pictures of an existing design, and you are ready to begin modeling this in Fusion 360. In this tutorial, we will take a look at how we can use these pictures to create this particular edge. This edge has a unique curvature looking from the top and looking from the side. Do take note that the sole focus of this tutorial is on going through the workflow on using these pictures as a guide to create this edge. I will not be going through the rest of the modeling process. Go to Insert, Canvas, and select the picture of the top view. You will be prompted to select a face for placing the picture. Since this is a picture of the top view, we shall select the top plane. At this point, the size of the picture is arbitrary. Before we make any adjustments to its position, I will recommend that you click OK and proceed to calibrate the picture according to its actual dimension. Once the picture is imported, a Canvases folder appears in the browser. Locate the existing canvas, right-click, and select Calibrate. Look normal to the top plane. At this point, you should have an idea of the overall length or the overall width of the model. In this case, I know that the length between these two points is 100 mm, so I will proceed to pick this point, and enter the distance. Take note that you will not actually be able to snap to the canvas. You will have to try your best to pick the points as accurately as you can. Once this is done, the canvas will be scaled accordingly. Locate the top canvas in the browser again, right-click, and select Edit Canvas. We need to position the canvas. You can move the picture in both the vertical and horizontal direction by dragging on a square. The arrows limit you to just vertical and horizontal movements. Dragging on this icon that looks like a fillet will scale the picture while maintaining the aspect ratio. Dragging on the horizontal and vertical lines will stretch the picture. Since we have already calibrated our picture, we do not need to adjust these. You can also flip the picture horizontally or vertically. I want to try to position the picture with respect to the origin in a way that makes sense for the rest of the modeling process. Usually, you will want the origin to be along the plane of symmetry. Let's try to match this point on the picture to the origin. If you turn on the Display True option, you will be able to see the canvas through any extrudes that you might be creating later. You can also adjust the opacity of the canvas. Click OK to confirm. Hide the top canvas. We are going to repeat the same steps for the picture on the right. We will place a picture on the right plane. Again, before adjusting the position, click OK to confirm. And calibrate the canvas. Go back into Edit Canvas and position this corner on the origin. Click OK. Unhide the top canvas. Hide the right canvas. Start a sketch on the top plane. We are going to sketch how this edge looks like from the top plane by tracing the top canvas. This is going to be a spline. Before we put down that spline, let's draw a few lines that will serve as a scaffold for the spline. Draw a vertical center line starting from the origin. Dimension it to the same length used to calibrate the canvas. Draw a horizontal line from the origin and end at the beginning of the spline. Draw another horizontal line starting from the other end of the vertical line and ending on the other point of the spline. Draw a third horizontal line and end it roughly at the turning point where the curvature changes direction. Dimension these points as is to lock them in. start a spline tool, and snap to each of these three points. Click on each of these three points to activate the spline handle. Rotating about the spline point will change the angle, while pulling along the length of the spline handle will adjust the curvature. Adjust the spline handles until you can get a close match to the canvas. Dimension the length and angle of the spline handles. Convert the straight lines to construction. Exit the sketch and hide the top canvas. And hide the right canvas. Start a sketch on the right plane. We will be tracing how the edge looks like from the right. It is composed of a straight line and a tangent arc. Start the line tool. At the end of the line, click and drag to drag out a tangent arc. Click on the horizontal vertical constraint and select these two points to vertically align them. Do the same for these two points. Fix these two points by dimensioning them. Adjust the middle point until the curve matches the canvas and dimension the point. Exit the sketch and hide the right canvas. To create this edge, we will need to project these two sketches onto each other. Since the resultant curve will be a 3D sketch, we can start a sketch on any plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersection Curve. Let's first try selecting the sketch on the right plane. As I click on the straight line, the select box jumps to the next curve. Even if I attempt to start over and control select the straight line and the arc is still selected as the second curve. This is a problem. The projection would only work if the straight line and the arc are recognized as a single continuous curve. It is a quirk of the command that only the second select box allows you to select multiple entities as one curve. So remove all existing selections. Click on the second select box and select the straight line and the arc. Click on the first select box and click on the spline. You can see a preview of the line in red. Let's hide the top and right sketches and unhide the canvases to see how the edge matches up with the respective canvases. We can now proceed to use this curve to create lofts for the model.